吉祥的高尔普尼玛主拆天殿的纪念日，我们荣幸地邀请到了圣巴迪维纳维纳什纳辛哈马拉给我们讲今天的早课，敬请聆听。Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。Om Jnanate Marandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindubhaye Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So because today is the auspicious day of the appearance day of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so we will speak something about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
由于今天是吉祥的 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的纪念日，所以今天我们来讲有关于 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的一些消息。
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai Nityananda Jai Advaita Chandra Jai Gaur Bhaktavinda. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is known as the Kali Yuga avatar, the incarnation of the Lord in the Kali Yuga.
由于 Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 被称为是 Kali Yuga avatar, 是卡利年代的主的化身。
So we want to understandhow to recognize who is actually the incarnation of the Supreme Lord. The incarnations of the Lord have to be understood on the basis of the evidence of scriptures.
主的化身辨认主的化身的根据是有经典的证据。
So, we find in the 11th canto Srimad Bhagavatam there is reference to the appearance of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
我们在圣典薄伽伐坛第十一篇当中看到有提及 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
It is mentionedin relation to a conversation between Karabhajana Muni, who was one of the nine Yogendras, who was talking to Maharaj Nemi.
这出自 Karabhajana Muni 和他是九位 Yogendra 之一与 Nemi 王之间的对话。
The nine Yogendras, they are all sons of Lord Rishabhdev. Lord Rishabhdev had 100 sons. Nine of them were called the nine Yogendras, and they were all preaching the message of Bhagavad philosophy.
Lord Rishabhdev has 100 sons, 其中有九位儿子被称为是九位 Yogendra.他们是巴格瓦的哲学的传道者。
So, Lord Chaitanya appears in the Kali Yuga in response to the pleas of Advaita Acharya.
主柴丹尼亚在卡利年代的降临是为了回应 Advaita Acharya 的恳求。
Advaita Acharya is an incarnation of Mahavishnu. And he came,
Advaita
came to deliver the fallen souls, but he saw they were so fallen, he thought he could not deliver them himself. So then he studied the scriptures and he saw that the Lord could be pleased by the offering of Ganges water and Tulsi leaves.
然后阿对达查里尔就学习了经典，他发现，用恒河水和托西叶子便可以取悦主。
So Advaita Acharya began to offer Tulsi leaves and Ganga water, and at the same time he would call out to the Lord in the spiritual world, and he would urge him to please come into this world to deliver the fallen soul.
阿杜特查尔雅便用恒河水和托西叶子来崇拜主，与此同时他也大声地呼唤主，从灵性世界降临尘世，请求主来降临世上，敦促主降临世上来拯救堕落的灵魂们。
So in response to the very devotional appealOf Advaita Acharya, the Lord appeared in this world.
就是为了回应阿杜特查尔雅充满奉爱的呼唤，所以主便降临尘世了。
When the Lord appeared.He appeared in the holy land of Mayapur. Mayapur is a place, it said that Srimati Radharani created the holy land of Mayapur just for the pleasure of Lord Krishna.
Srimati Radharani 只是为了取悦主 Krishna, 所以便创造了圣地 Mayapur.
The Lord, of course, we know the Lord appears in Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, the mood of the Lord is different from the Lord in Mayapur.
众所周知，主是显现在 Vrindavan， 然而 Vrindavan 的心绪有别于 Mayapur 的心绪。
Although we say Vrindavan and Mayapur are non-different, still there's a different mood when the Lord appears in these places.
尽管我们说 Vrindavan 和 Mayapur 是毫无二致的。但是仍然当主在这两个地方显现的时候，他们是怀着不同的心态。
All the holy places which are in Vrindavan are also there in Mayapur.
在 Vrindavan, 有什么样的圣地，在 Mayapur 也同样存在这些圣地。
And the Lord who comes in Vrindavan is the same Lord who comes in Mayapur.
降临到 Vrindavan 的主，这同一位主又降临到了 Mayapur。
Yeah, it's pointed out that there are three incarnations of the Lord. In this one Divya Yuga, there are three incarnations of the Lord.
据说在这个 Divya Yuga 年代。有三位主的化身。
Adivya Yuga means the four ages together. The golden, the Satya Yuga, the Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga. That is one Divya Yuga. And in every day of Brahma, there are 1,000 Divya Yugas.
Yuga, 而在 主 Brahma 的一天当中有1000个 Divya 年代。
So it's pointed out there are only 3 incarnations in, there are 3 forms, the Lord appears 3 times. In this one Divya Yuga, the Lord appears. And 3 different personalities.
据说就在这个 Divya 年代，主是以三位人物的形象显现在这个 Divya 年代。
So, the Lord who appears in Dwapara Yuga is Lord Krishna. And that same Lord Krishna comes again in Kali Yuga as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes. He is Krishna, but he comes in a different mood. He comes in the mood of a devotee.
Sri Krishna, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 就是 Krishna 本人。然而，他这次降临的时候呢，是怀着不同的心态降临的。他是以一位奉献者的心态降临。
Yeah, he wants to experience the pleasure of being a devotee.
他希望体验做一位奉献者的快乐。
And the greatest devotee of Lord Krishna are the gopis. And among all the gopis, the most exalted of all the gopis is Srimati Radharani.
主 Krishna 最伟大的奉献者是 Gopi 牧牛姑娘们，而在芸芸的牧牛姑娘当中，最崇高的一位牧牛姑娘是 Srimati Radharani。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna, but he wants to cultivate that mood which Srimati Radharani has.
尽管 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu是 Krishna 本人，但是他希望能培养 Srimati Radharani 的心态。
So when Lord Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago, at that time Lord Krishna could see that Srimati Radharani was getting more pleasure from his pastimes than he was getting.
当主 Krishna 在5000年前显现的时候， Krishna 就看出 Srimati Radharani 从他们的消时光当中获得的快乐大于他本人从这些消时光当中体验到的快乐。
Yeah. Srimati Radharani was enjoying the wonderful qualities in Lord Krishna.
Srimati Radharani, 他就非常享受 Sri Krishna 身上的这些品质。
And she was also enjoying having a loving relationship with Krishna.
她也完全沉浸在跟 Krishna 的爱的关系中。
And she was also enjoying a special pleasure when she saw that Krishna liked her very much.
当她看到 主 Krishna 非常钟爱他自己的时候，他从中得到了特殊的快乐和享受。
So in this way, the pleasure of which Radharani was having was many thousands of times greater than the pleasure of Lord Krishna.
就这样，是 Srimati Radharani 享受的快乐要比 Krishna 的享受的快乐要高一千上千倍。
Of course, this is a very esoteric reason. This is a very confidential reason for the purpose of Lord Chaitanya's advent in the world.
当然，这是 Chaitanya。马巴布降临到世上的非常机密的原因。
The external reason for the appearance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was to establish the Yuga Dharma.
而是 Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 显现的外在原因是为了降临来建立年代 Yuga Dharma, 年代宗教年代大法。
The Yuga Dharma, the process by which people can become self-realized in this Kali Yuga, is through the chanting of the holy name.
在这个卡里年代，人们获得自我觉悟的方法程序就是通过唱诵主的圣名。
In every age, there's a process for self-realization.
在每个年代都有一个自我觉悟的方法。
For example, in the Satya Yuga, the process is meditation, because people live a very long time, they can sit and meditate, and they can achieve self-realization.
例如，在萨提亚年代的自我觉悟的方法就是冥想，因为他们寿命很长。他们可以长时间地坐在那里冥想来达到自我觉悟。
Now in Satya Yuga, people lived 100,000 years, but in the next stage, Treta Yuga, the people were not so pious, so the duration of life was reduced to 10,000 years. And in that age, the process was to do fires, to do some yajna, to perform a sacrifice.
在萨提亚年代的人们的寿命是长达10万年，而到了 Treta 年代，人们并没有那么虔诚，所以他们的寿命就缩减到了10,000年。在 Treta 年代的觉悟自我的方法是 Yagya， 通过做祭祀。
And then in the next age, Dwapara Yuga, the piety of people was reduced still further.So the duration of life just became 1,000 years. And in that age, the process was temple worship.
而到了 Dwapara 年代，人们的虔诚呢，也就越来越少了，所以他们的寿命也就减少到了1,000年，1,000岁。这个年代的自我觉悟的方法是庙宇崇拜。
But we should understand.That in every one of the ages, they could also chant the holy name.
与此同时，我们要明白，在每一个年代，人们都可以唱诵圣名。
Yes, we see how Ajamila chanted the holy name. That was not Kali Yuga.Dhruva Maharaj chanted the holy name. It wasn't Kali Yuga. And Draupadi chanted the holy name. It wasn't Kali Yuga.
那么在经典中记述的，阿扎米尔他唱诵了圣名，他所处的年代并不是卡里年代，而 Dhruva Maharaj 也唱诵了圣名，他所处的也并非卡里年代。而 Draupadi 唱诵圣名的年代也并非卡里年代。
So in every age, there was the chanting of the holy name, but there were other processes also by which they could become perfect.
尽管在每一个年代都有着唱颂圣名的方法，但是与此同时还有着其他的觉悟自我的方法。
But in the Kali Yuga, there's only one way. There's only the chanting of the holy name. There's no other way.
而卡里年代呢，只剩下唯一的唱颂圣名的方法了，别无他法。
People in the Kali Yuga are very fallen, very sinful, so the duration of life is no more than 100 years.
Kali 年代的人们呢，非常的堕落，罪恶昭彰，因此他们的寿命呢，不超过100年。
So we see Lord Chaitanya appearing in the Kali Yuga to perform the Sankirtan, to establish the Sankirtan, the chanting of the holy names.
主柴丹念马哈帕布他就降临到了卡里年代来确立 Sankirtan, 唱颂圣名的方法。
And from the very beginning of his life, he was engaged in chanting of the holy name.
而且呢，他从一出生开始呢，就让人们唱颂圣名。
On the very day of his appearance, this day of Gaur Purnima, more than 500 years ago, there was a solar eclipse, and at that time,Because of the inauspicious nature of solar eclipses, everyone chants the holy name.
在朱柴天尼亚显现的，就是这一天五百多年前的这一天，格尔普尼玛这天呢，发生了 solar eclipse means sun or moon.
Sun.
发生了日食，所以在这一日食发生日食的这一天呢，人们纷纷都唱诵圣名，为了来抵消不吉祥的影响。
This was an indication of the future of the child that he is coming to propagate this, to encourage people everywhere in the chanting of the holy names of the Lord.
这就预示了这个孩子的未来，这个孩子未来将要传播传扬圣名，他会鼓励每一个地方的人们来唱诵圣名。
So as a small baby, you know, babies,When you bring up a baby, the babies will cry sometimes. So, like other children, sometimes this baby, the son of Sachi, he will cry. And in order to get the baby to stop crying, the people who are taking care of the baby would have to chant the holy name.
我们都知道，养育小婴儿的过程当中。会发现这个小婴儿会哭泣啼哭，所以为了让这个小婴儿呢停止啼哭，照顾这小婴儿的人们便会唱诵圣名。
This was a game which Lord Chaitanya would play as a child. He will cry.And the mothers, the ladies will come and try to care for the baby. They will hold the baby and rock the baby, cuddle the baby, try to get the baby to stop crying. But until they chant the holy name, the baby would keep crying.
这便是这个小婴儿的游戏。当这些小孩子哭泣啼哭的时候，这些妈妈们、女士们便过来来哄他，来抱着他，来摇他。但是除非他们开始唱诵圣名，否则的话，这个孩子会不停的啼哭。
So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was encouraging the chanting of the holy name. Then, as he began to grow, he continued to perform this chanting of the holy name.
以这种方式，使 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 鼓励人们唱诵圣名。当他长大的过程当中，他依然是鼓励着人们去唱诵圣名。
As a young man, sometimes he would go to travel to different places.
作为年轻人，他有时候会到不同的地方旅行。
And he would also, as well as do some teaching, he was a teacher of logic, he would also teach the chanting of the holy names.
他作为老师，在教学的过程中，他在教授逻辑的课程中，也会让学生们晨念诵圣名。
So, Srila Prabhupada points out that devotee of Krishna doesn't just only speak philosophy, but he also teaches the chanting of the holy name.
圣帕帕德指出，主 Krishna 的奉献者会不仅仅会教授哲学，与此同时也会教授圣名。
We want to encourage people everywhere to chant the holy name. And it said, one's spiritual life begins with the chanting of the holy name.
所以我们希望鼓励每一个地方的人们都开始唱诵圣名，因为灵性生活就始于唱诵圣名。
So when the baby was born, then they had to consider what would be the suitable name for this child.
当孩子出生之际，人们就考虑，该给孩子起一个什么合适的名字呢？
So Mother Sachi, the mother of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, she had given birth before, but a number of times the children had died at birth.
Sachi, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的母亲 Sachi, 之前呢也生过几个孩子，但是他们都夭折了。
It said she lost 8 female children before she could give birth to one child.
据说他在就是他在生育了一个成功的生育了一个孩子之前呢，曾经有八个女婴都夭折了。
Then she had one son. The first son was the older brother of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. His name was Vishwarup.
之后 ，Sachi 母亲成功的诞下一名男婴。他是马哈帕布的，他的大哥，他的名字叫 Vishwarup。
And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was, his home was situated under the shade of a neem tree. So the ladies considered that this neem tree, this will help to protect the mother from any inauspiciousness.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的家呢，就在一棵巨大的 neem树的树荫之下。人们认为这个 neem 树呢可以保护母亲免遭不吉祥的因素。
And they thought, in order to protect the child from any inauspiciousness, we will give the name Nimai, which comes from the neem tree. That indicates antiseptic properties.
为了保护孩子免遭 这个不吉祥因素的打扰，所以人那所以便给他起名为尼麦。尼麦这个名字是和尼姆树有关，这个
antiseptic，
what does it mean antiseptic
means will not be contaminated， it can purify even something which is impure。
哦，所以这个名字呢，它的意思就是说它不会受到污染，而且它会有净化作用。
You can check A-N-T-I
yes.
S-E-P-T-I-C
A-N-T-I-S
E-P
S-E-P okay. Antiseptic 这个 antiseptic 这个意思就是有防腐抗菌的作用，它的目的是防腐剂抗菌剂，可以它这个you mean the neem tree has the antiseptic purpose?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry. 这个印度的应该是苦碱树，这个树呢它有抗菌防腐的作用。
Now, if you eat the neem leaves, the neem leaves are very powerful. They can be very good for your health if you can eat a few neem leaves.
Neem 树叶就是印度的这个，就这个 neem 树叶，它是非常有力量的，它非常有助于健康。如果人每天吃上几片树叶，这种 neem 树叶对健康是大有好处的。
Of course, it's very bitter tasting.
它是非常非常苦的。
Yeah, just like Chinese medicine, you know, bitter things are good for you.
对，就好像中国咱们中医里的那开的中药特别苦，但是它是特别有用的。
And so they often will take neem leaves and they will cut them up into very small pieces and make a little mixture and you put it in the food, it's very good.
人们便取几片那个这个 neem 树叶切碎之后呢，混合在食物里，他们会这么吃饭。
We have also toothpaste made from the neem.
还有用 neem 树叶或者树枝做的牙膏。
So anyway, this name Nimai, this was given to the child. One name given to the child.
无论如何。尼麦是这个孩子的名字之一。
And the astrologer, Nilamba Chakravarti, he was actually the father of Sachi, the grandfather from the mother's side. He was an astrologer, and he gave the name Vishwambar, the maintainer of the universe.
他的祖父也就是 Sachi 母亲的父亲，Nilambar
Chakravarti，
他是这个 Nilambar Chakravarti， 然后他给尼麦又起名为 Vishwambara， 意思是宇宙的维系者。
And then he got another, because he was always getting people to chant the holy name,And because his skin was a golden color, it was given the name Gaurahari.
由于他鼓励人们唱诵圣名，而且他是肤色肤如龙金，因此他获得了一个名字叫 Gaurahari.
Those were three names which were given for the child when he was young.
这三个名字呢，就是在这个孩子小的时候，人们给他起的这三个名字。
So it was predicted. I was saying that the Lord's appearance in this world has to be established by evidence from the scriptures. So this one verse in the 11th canto Srimad Bhagavatam describes how the Lord will appear in Kali Yuga.
那么前面说过呢，一个化身的显现呢，必须它有经典的证据作为支持。因此，在《圣典博伽瓦坛》的第十一篇当中，就有一个师节作为证据。
Yeah, in the Satya Yuga, Lord comes in a red color. Oh no, white color. White color in the Satya Yuga, and then in the Treta Yuga, next he comes in the red color.
主在萨提亚年代他的肤色是白色的，主在崔特年代的肤色是红色的。
And then, of course, the Dwapara Yuga comes as Lord Krishna. He's a blackish color.
在多尔帕年代呢，主 Krishna 显现，他的肤色是黝黑的。
So it was described in Krishna's pastimes when.Garga Muni came to give the name for Krishna and Balaram. Garga Muni was sent to the home of Nanda Maharaj by Vasudev to give the name for the two children, Krishna and Balaram.
在 Krishna 的那消时光当中呢， Garga Muni 便被邀请来为 Krishna 和 Balarama 起名字。当时是在南的马哈拉的家中，是 Vasudeva 派 Garga Muni 来给他们命起名。
So at that time, Garga Muni told Nanda Maharaj about Krishna.
在那个时候 ，Garga Muni 就对南的马哈拉讲述了关 Krishna 的事情。
And he told him, he said, this child appears in different colors in different ages.
他说这个孩子在不同的年代以不同的肤色显现。
And he said he appeared in the white, in the red, in the yellow, and he said now he's come in this blackish color.
他告诉南的大君，这个孩子他曾经先前以白色的肤色，红皮肤。黄皮肤显现，而现在呢，他以这个黝黑的皮肤肤色显现。
So the yellow color in Kali, that is actually Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He's a golden color. Gold is yellowish.
因此，这个黄色的皮肤指的就是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。他因为他的肤色就像黄金一样，因为黄金的肤色，黄金是黄色的。
So, in the 11th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, it describes that the Lord will come. It says, the verse says, Krishna Varnam Tevisha Krishnam. It says that in the Kali Yuga, in the Lord's incarnation in the Kali Yuga, his business will be Krishna.
这节诗呢，出自《圣典博伽瓦坛》第十一篇。这个诗节的意思是说，在卡里年代，Krishna's business is Krishna, right?
Yeah.
Krishna 的事物呢，就是 Krishna.
Yeah, the Lord's incarnation in the Kali Yuga will be propagating Krishna.
主在卡里年代的这个使命就是去传扬 Krishna.
No, the Lord's incarnation in the Kali Yuga.When the Lord comes in the Kali Yuga, his main purpose will be to propagate the consciousness of Krishna.
Sorry, 那我再翻译一遍，刚才翻译的不准，就是主在卡利年代的化身，他的目的是，是去传播 Krishna 的知觉。
We use the word Varna, just like there's, the society is divided into four different Varnas. There is the Brahmana Varna, the Kshatriya Varna, the Vaishya Varna, and the Sudra Varna.
Varna 这个词的是指的是社会四阶层，有婆罗门阶层、沙地利阶层、Vaishya阶层、书者阶层。
So the same word is used to say Krishna Varna. The occupation will be Krishna.
这个世界里，的这个词是 Krishna Varna， 指的就是 Krishna 的职业。
There will be, for example, the chanting of the holy name of Krishna, and there will be the preaching of the message of Krishna, and description of the glories of Krishna, and the worship of Krishna.
Krishna Varna, Krishna 的职业呢，就是包括唱诵 Krishna 的圣名，传播 Krishna 的信息，描述 Krishna 的荣耀，还有崇拜 Krishna.
So this is the meaning of Krishna Varna.
这就是 Krishna Varna 这个词的意思。
The Lord is going to come, and he's going to teach people to worship Krishna.
主将要降临，而他的降临的目的就是教导人们有关于 Krishna.
And when you want to teach someone, you have to show them by example.You have to do it yourself and show people how to do it.
当去教导别人的时候呢，自己就要做一个表率，自己首先就要向别人展示如何去做。
Just like 5,000 years ago, Lord Krishna spoke the Bhagavad Gita, and he instructed everyone to surrender to him.
正像五千年前，主 Krishna 讲述了国家梵歌，他训示人人都应该向他臣服。
So he gave the instruction, but he didn't demonstrate how to do it. Therefore, he came 500 years ago. Again, he came again, and this time he was known as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but actually he's Krishna.
但是。在五千年前，主 Krishna 给人们留下了这个训示，他并没有亲身示范该如何去做，因此在五百年前，他再次以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的身份降临，但他实际上就是 Krishna 本人。
But his color is not Krishna. Krishna, the word Krishna can also mean blackish, but Although the Lord is coming, and he's Krishna himself, but he's not blackish. So it says, Akrishna, he's not blackish color. Instead of a blackish color, he's come as in a golden complexion.
然而，在他的肤色并不是 Krishna. Krishna 的意思就是黝黑的。他虽然是 Krishna 本人，但他的肤色并不是黑色的，他是阿 Krishna， 他的肤色是熔金一样。
So this was the description, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he's not coming alone, but he's coming with all of his associates, with all of his friends and devotees. They come together to help him to propagate the message of Krishna.
就是对 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的描述， 然而他不是孤身一人而来，他带着他的同游、他的朋友、他的奉献者一起降临。他这些人是为了帮助他传播 Krishna 的讯息。
And the method which they're using to propagate this message of Krishna is by doing Sankirtan, the congregational chanting of the holy name.
而他们传播 Krishna 信息的方法是 Sankirtan, 迪颂主的圣名。
This is called a yagna. This is a, the Sankirtan is also a yagya. It's a sacrifice. It's something which is done. When we sacrifice something, you do it for the pleasure of others. So the Sankirtan yagya is something which we do for the pleasure of Lord Krishna and for the pleasure of other living entities.
在雅吉亚的举行呢，一定是为了另外一个人的快乐而去做的。而 Sankirtan Yagya Sankirtan 其颂圣名记是为了主 Krishna 的快乐以及别的众生的快乐而举行的。
So devotees of the Lord who have a good intelligenceIt's mentioned in the verse, Sumedasaha, that those people who have a pure brain, they will take part in this Sankirtan, in this process of chanting the holy names of God.
那些有着良好智性的主的奉献者，他们就会 Sumedaha.他们被称为是苏妹的哈，他们有着纯净大脑，他们会参加 Sankirtan 这个其颂神的圣名的大法。
We see in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna takes that same word, Medasaha, meaning intelligence, and he describes people who have very poor intelligence. Their brain is described as alpa.Medasa. Alpa means very small.
这个相应的词，这个词也可以就是在《薄伽梵歌》当中，主 Krishna 也提到了这个词 ，Sumedalpa, Medasaha. 他这时候用的是 alpa. Alpa 的意思就是非常可怜的，非常小智的。
So those people of small intelligence, they will worship other gods. They will worship the demigods to get material benefit.
小智者崇拜半神人来获取物质好处。
So in this way, the appearance of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was predicted.5,000 years ago in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
就这样 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的显现就在5000年前便撰写的圣典薄伽瓦坛当中便早已得到了预言。
But there are other verses also which predict the appearance of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
除此之外还有别的诗节也预言了 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的显现。
There's a very important verse which comes in the Mahabharata, which describes also the activities of Lord Chaitanya.
在 Mahabharata 这部重要的书籍当中，也有一个形容 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 活动的诗节。
There it describes how.In his early pastimes, the Lord will appear as a householder.
那里就形容说，在主的早期的逍遥时光当中，他显现为一名居士。
When Lord Chaitanya appeared, well, his father died, And his mother felt very sorry when the father disappeared, that she wanted her son to get married. So she arranged that Nimai would marry.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 显现之后，他长大成人，他的父亲便过世了，他母亲感到十分的难过，便希望自己的儿子结婚。
The older brother, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's older brother, he had left home and gone off and taken sannyas.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的大哥，他离家出走，他就当了托钵僧 sannyas。
So Mother Sachi had lost the eldest son because he'd taken sannyas, means he won't come home again.
Sachi 母亲的长子，当进入了气绝阶层，这就意味着他一去不复返了。
So she did not want the same thing to happen to the younger son, who was Nimai. So she thought, we'll get him married. So Nimai was married, but at one point, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had gone to travel in order to make some, to collect some resources for the maintenance. So at that time, the wife died.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 结婚之后，他有一次呢，便外出旅行，为维持家庭生活呢，去赚一些钱。在此期间，他的妻子过世了。
So, when the first wife died, then Mother Sachi, then they arranged another marriage. A second wife was arranged for Mahaprabhu, for Chaitanya.
Chaitanya 的第一个妻子过世，第一位妻子离开人世之后，他的母亲便为他安排了第二次婚姻，所以他就有了第二位妻子。
So that was while he was a young man. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spent the first 24 years of his life as a householder.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的人生的头24年，他的年轻，他的24岁之前呢，他曾经一度是居士。
And we have to understand that Nimai had a very handsome body.He was very tall, and he had very beautiful lotus eyes, which were spread across his face.
Nimai, 年轻的尼麦，他高大英俊，他长着长长的莲花眼。
And his arms were very long. His arms went down to his knees.
他的臂膀。长极非常修长，长及他的膝部。
And it said, his body was smeared with the pulp of sandalwood. And so sandalwood, it looks like it's a yellow color. You see, it's like the color of his skin.
据说他身上涂着檀香浆液。檀香浆液同样它也是黄色的。
And then the Mahabharata, in this verse from the Mahabharata, it says that in his later pastimes, he will accept the sannyas order.
在 Mahabharata 这部书中就 记述了马哈帕布在他后期的消失光中他会进入气绝阶层。
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did that at the age of 24. He gave up his family life and he became a sannyasi.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就是这样，他在二十四岁那年放弃了家居生活，成为了一位托钵僧 sannyasi.
And as a sannyasi, he was peaceful and self-controlled.
他这位 sannyasi 他平和自制。
And he was full of devotion for the Supreme Lord.
他心中充满对至尊主的奉爱之情。
And he would silence the impersonalist non-devotees.
他会让那些非人格主义的非奉献者们让他们闭口。
So we can see this is the evidence from the Mahabharata also to confirm that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
所以出自马哈巴尔的当中的诗节同样证明了柴丹尼亚马哈巴布就是至尊人格守神。
So, we should understand, Lord Chaitanya's personality is very, very attractive and very pleasing.
我们要明白柴丹尼亚马哈帕布的他的性格他是非常有魅力的也非常令人愉悦。
And wherever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would go, Mahaprabhu would go, he would be singing and dancing and chanting the holy names.
无论他柴丹尼亚马哈帕布去哪里他都会唱歌跳舞唱诵圣名。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu only talked philosophy with some special people.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 只和某一些特殊的人谈论哲学。
If there was some great personality, just like when Lord Chaitanya went to Jagannath Puri, he met with the person in charge of the temple there, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu talked philosophy with him.
当主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 去扎格纳的库瑞的时候呢，他就和那里负责庙宇的 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 谈论哲学。
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was an elderly man. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was just a young man at first.When he first came to Puri, he was only 24. He'd just taken sannyas. He was still a young man.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 已经年事已高，是位长者。而 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 当时呢，还正是年轻的时候，他们便谈论了哲学。那时候他刚刚当了 sannyasi.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he thought that this young man, that it will be difficult for him to maintain sannyas, because as people grow older, then they become sometimes restless in the position of renunciation.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 便想，这位年轻人呢，可能很难保持一个 sannyasi 托钵僧的身份，因为当 sannyasi 变上了岁数之后呢，他可能会内心感到不安，他对他的气绝阶层的地位呢感到有不安。
So he thought, I will teach him philosophy. I will teach him the philosophy of Vedanta Sutra. And if he has a good knowledge, it will help him to maintain the sannyas ashram.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 便想，我要教导这位年轻人Vedanta Sutra 的哲学，这样呢，就会帮助他保持他的sannyasi 的 ashram。
And so the Bhattacharya, he tried to teach to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but in the end, it was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu who taught him, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made him a devotee.
起初呢是 Bhattacharya 在真正的教导 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 但后来就变成了 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 教导了 Bhattacharya,把他转变成了一名奉献者。
Bhattacharya had not been a devotee before. He'd been a Mayavadi. He'd been a great scholar of logic and philosophy, but he was not a devotee. But when he met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu changed him and made him into a devotee.
Bhattacharya 本来呢不是奉献者，他精通哲学啊，还有逻辑，他是一位大学者，他并不是奉献者。然而 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 把他转变成了一名奉献者。
Anyway, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to live in Jagannath Puri as a sannyasi, but previously he'd been living in Mayapur.And in Mayapur, the mood was very joyful.
无论如何 ,Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 后期的时候就去居住在 Jagannath 的 Puri。然而他早期的时候是居住在 Mayapur 的这种氛围啊是非常欢快的氛围。
The pastimes in Mayapur are very...pleasing, all about Lord Chaitanya or Nimai and the different activities which he's doing. He's having a lot of fun and he's enjoying himself.
In Mahapur, his spending time is very delightful. He, as Nimai, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, at that time was called Nimai.他的活动呢是非常快乐的，他是在那里享受着快乐。
As a young boy, you know, young boys can be very mischievous. So Nimai was like that. He was very mischievous. He got up, he did a lot of things which sometimes made people angry at him.
所以我们都知道，小男孩是非常淘气的。Nimai, 小 Nimai 也是这样的，非常非常的淘气。有的时候他搞得人们对他很生气。
When people would be chanting the Gayatri in the Ganga, he would come and pull the legs.
就当那些婆罗门在恒河站在恒河水中，在那里默念 Gayatri 的时候 ，Nimai 呢就会在潜到水里去拽他们的腿。
And if somebody was sitting meditating along the side of the Ganga, Nimai would throw water on them.
而当有人在那里坐在恒河水中坐在那里冥想的时候呢 ，Nimai 就会朝他们身上泼水。
And sometimes Nimai would also tease the young girls. He'd tell the young girls that when they would come to worship the demigods.He would tell them, you should worship me. Instead of offering to demigods, you should offer to me. And he said, I am the source of all the demigods.
When those young girls came to the 恒河岸边来崇拜半神人的时候，尼麦呢就会逗弄他们，就逗弄他们说，你们应该把贡品都献给我，因为我是半神人的源头。
And sometimes When people had a baby, Nimai would come and pinch the baby, make the baby cry. Other times, Nimai would cover himself with a blanket, and he would go into the people's gardens, and he would take any fruit which was there, and he'd do damage to their garden.
他有的时候还会披上一条毯子，潜到人们的花园当中呢，去那里摘树上的果实，或者是把这些花，把他们的花园呢毁坏。
And sometimes people would be complaining to his father about his behavior, and his father would get quite angry at him and chastise him.
人们便会去他父亲那里向他抱怨他的所作所为，他的父亲呢就会对他生气，训斥他。
Even his father was called Jagannath Mishra, so sometimes his father would have a dream, and in the dream, a Brahmin would come and tell him that, you know, you should not speak so harsh words to your son. You do not know his identity.
His father's name is Jagannath Mishra. Once, in his dream, there was a Brahmin who came and told him,你不应该对你的儿子说话这样的尖刻，你不知道他的身份。
So, Jagannath Mishra would then talk to the person in the dream, and he would say, "Well, I'm his father. It doesn't matter who my son is. It's my duty to chastise him."
Jagannath Mishra 呢，就在梦中呢和这位婆罗门还在交谈，对他说，嗯，我是他的父亲。不管他的身份如何呢，我都有职责来教育他。
So Jagannath Mishra and Sachimata, they're none different from Vasudeva and Devaki, or they're like the mother and father of Lord Krishna.
Jagannath Mishra 和 Sachi 母亲呢，就好像 Vasudeva 和 Devaki， 是 Krishna 的父母那样。
Or Nanda and Yashoda, who were Krishna's
father. 同样呢，就像 Nanda 和 Yashoda 是 Krishna 的父母那样， Jagannath Mishra 和 Sachi 妈妈呢是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的父母。
But we want to understand that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes in Mayapur, very joyful, very full of mercy and very happy. But later, after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu becomes a sannyasi, then the mood is different and becomes very serious.
So we need to understand Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Mayapur 的消时光呢是非常的喜乐，喜乐融融的，是非常的仁慈的，快乐的。但后期他当了 sannyasi 托钵僧之后，他心绪便转变了，他变得非常认，非常严肃认真。
So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself, and he's coming to establish, to give all of us this chanting of the holy name.In this form of the Sankirtan movement, that this is the process by which we can know Krishna in the Kali Yuga.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就是 Krishna 本人，他降临的目的是要给予我们圣名，来传扬 Sankirtan 七颂圣名运动。他的方法呢，就是通过给予 Krishna 人们 Krishna 的名字。
While Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was living in Mayapur, He told Lord Nityananda and also Haridas Thakur that they should go to everyone's door and they should knock on the door. And when the people opened the door, they should offer, they should fall at their feet, offer obeisances to them. And they should beg them, please read the books about Krishna, worship Krishna, and chant the name of Krishna.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就叮嘱尼提亚南达和哈尔达斯塔库去挨家挨户的敲他们的门，当他们开门的时候，他们要向这些他们的这些房子中的人呢禀拜他们的族，恳求他们读阅读有关 Krishna 的书籍，崇拜 Krishna， 唱诵 Krishna 的名字。
So you can see the life of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that, he in the beginning he was a scholar, and at, by the age of 11 he opened his own school and began to teach.
查丹尼亚 Mahaprabhu 他的在他人生的早期呢，他曾经是个大学者，他十一岁的时候就开办了自己的学校。
Then, after his father passed away from the world, then he decided he should go. He went to a place called Gaya, and it was in Gaya he got initiation.
当查丹尼亚·马哈帕布的父亲离开人世之后，他便下决心去嘎雅。他是在嘎雅得到了启迪。
His spiritual master was Ishwara Puri, who was a disciple of Madhavendra Puri.
他的灵性导师名字是 Ishwara Puri, 而 Ishwara Puri 是 Madhavendra Puri 的门徒。
Madhavendra Puri was initiated in the line of Madhva Acharya.
Madhavendra Puri 是在 Madhva Acharya 的传系当中得到启迪的。
And Madhavendra Puri brought the mood of pure love for Krishna, the mood of spontaneous devotion.Raga Bhakti into the line of the cyclic succession.
Madhavendra Puri 呢，他带来的是，他带来的心态是对 Krishna 的纯粹之爱，是自发的奉爱之情 ，Raga Bhakti.
So,
把这种 Raga Bhakti 带到了使徒传记当中。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wants to give people the chance to go not just to Vaikuntha, but he wants them to go to Goloka.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 他希望给予人们的机会呢，是不仅仅能够去 Vaikuntha, 而且他们人们可以去 Goloka.
So to go to Goloka, we have to cultivate the mood of the people of Vrindavan.
为了去成功的到达 Goloka, 我们需要培养 Vrindavan 居民的心绪。
And if we see we're doing that by our different devotional activities.By our worship of the deities, by our chanting of the holy name, and singing songs about Krishna.
我们是通过不同的奉爱服务来做到这一点的。我们崇拜 Krishna, 唱诵 Krishna 的名字，来歌唱 Krishna.
So. I was listening to a Prabhupada lecture just yesterday. Someone was asking Prabhupada how we could serve the gopis, how we could cultivate the mood of the gopis.
Maharaj, 昨天呢听了一个帕帕德的音频，有人就问帕帕德如何培养、如何服务勾皮牧牛姑娘们，如何培养牧牛姑娘的心态呢
？So Prabhupada said, first you must become liberated. First you have to give up your sinful activities and come to the platform of pure devotion. Then you can think about.
所以帕帕德的回答是说，首先呢要达到解脱的层面，要放弃罪恶的活动，要来到纯粹奉爱的层面，然后再去考虑这些事情。
You have to give up all your activities which have nothing to do with Krishna.
人们应当放弃那些和 Krishna 无关的活动。
We have to become fixed in the chanting of the holy names of Lord Krishna. And we have to be properly engaged in the mood of being the servant of Krishna and give up the idea that we are the master.
We must 处在做 Krishna 仆人的地位上，放弃想要当主人的念头。
So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is described by Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami was a direct disciple of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when he met Lord Chaitanya, he offered a nice verse.Glorifying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 他有一个直系的门徒 Rupa Goswami. 当 Rupa Goswami 遇见 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的时候，便献上了一首优美的祷文来荣耀他。
So he said, Namo Mahabhadanaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namane Gauratvishe Namaha. That of all of Krishna's incarnations, this form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the most merciful.
在所有 Krishna 的化身众多化身当中 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的形象是最为仁慈的形象
He is giving the highest thing He is giving Krishna Prema love of Krishna to everyone
他给予的是最崇高的礼物 Krishna Prema 他给予每一个人对 Krishna 的爱
And we also sing a beautiful song which is glorifying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as well as Nityananda.
We also sing a beautiful song to glorify Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda.
Paramakaruna Pahudvijana Nitai Gora Chandra.Sabha avatara tsarasiromani kevala ananda kanda. So this song is saying that there are many incarnations of Krishna, but Chaitanya and Nityananda are the most merciful because they are giving a process which is simply joyful.
这首诗歌曲的大意是说，就 Krishna 在 Krishna 的众多化身当中， Chaitanya 和 Nityananda 是最为仁慈的，因为他们给予人们的方法呢，只是喜乐的方法。
Just simply chanting and dancing, it's a very joyful process.
仅仅是唱诵舞蹈，这是一个喜乐的方法。
Every day here in the Holy Dham in Mayapur, devotees are having wonderful kirtan, and devotees, people from everywhere, are joining in the chanting and dancing.
每天呢，在圣地马尔普这里呢，每天都进行着美丽的 kirtan， 来自全世界各地的人们都纷纷地加入唱诵和舞蹈的行列。
So we actually see how people who are materialistic and who are not devotees, how they can be changed simply by meeting the devotees, simply by contacting the Sankirtan movement.
我们亲眼看到那些物质主义的非奉献者们是如何改变的，仅仅是见到奉献者们，接触奉献者们，接触这个 Sankirtan 运动，他们的人生便发生了翻天覆地的改变。
So this Sankirtan movement, this is the process which is given to us by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He took part in Sankirtan every day.
这一齐颂圣名运动 Sankirtan 运动是由 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 给予我们的，而他本人呢，每天都参加 Sankirtan。
And when he was here in Mayapur, of course the Lord is always here in Mayapur, it's his eternal home, but when he was manifesting his pastimes 500 years ago, he would perform Sankirtan every night.
当然马普是主永恒的家园，但是当500多年前他展示他的逍遥时光的时候，他每天晚上都从事 Sankirtan 集诵圣名。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would meet with all of the devotees in the home of Shiva's Pandit, and the whole night the devotees would chant the holy name constantly.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 会在 Shiva's Pandit 的家中会见所有的奉献者，他们整夜通宵都恒常地唱诵圣名。
The kirtans in the home of Shiva's Thakur were very confidential. They were not open to the public. They were only for the very special devotees.
在 Shiva's Thakur 的家中所进行的 kirtan 是非常机密的，是 不对公众开放的，只有那些特殊的奉献者才得以加入。
Later on, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking sannyas, then he brought the Sankirtan movement out of the temple and out of the private place, he brought it into the public to everyone.
后来 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 当了托钵僧 Sannyasi 之后，他便把 Sankirtan 带出了庙宇，把它带出了这个私人的场所，把它带到了公开场合，带到了每一个人面前。
We like to distribute the message of Krishna to one and all without discrimination, without any distinction of who is qualified and who is not.
我们希望，把 Krishna 信息派发给每一个人。不加分辨的去区分谁有资格谁没有资格。
we often see there's a tendency to discriminate about who is qualified and who is not. But in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teaching, there is no discrimination. Everyone is qualified.
我们看到呢，有这样一种倾向，就是去分辨，谁有资格，谁没有资格。但是我们看到，从Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的榜样当中看到呢，他教导每一个人，实际上每一个人都是有资格的。
So this is the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to give mercy everywhere without distinction. We give the holy name, we give Krishna prasadam, we give literature about Krishna consciousness. Somehow or other, we try to give people the mercy of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以这边是他的心态。就是给予仁慈的心态，到处的给予，不加分辨的，到处给予这份仁慈，给予人们 Krishna 的圣名，给予 prasadam， 给予人们 Krishna 知觉的文献。所以我们也要努力的给予人们 Chaitanya， 除 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这份仁慈。
So the first festival.Commemorating this event, the appearance of Lord Chaitanya in this world, this was celebrated first of all by a great devotee called Narottam Das Thakur.
就是庆祝主 Chaitanya 显现的，这个庆典，这个伟大的庆典呢，是由一位伟大的奉献者叫 Narottam Das Thakur 始发的、首创的。
And he organized a big festival, and he invited all the people to come. They came from very far away. They came walking for many, many days to come to be with him to celebrate this festival.
他就组织了盛大的节日，邀请了。邀请了各方人士，人们从大老远的，步行许多天来到他这里，和他一起来庆祝这个节日。
So we're continuing today. Everywhere, wherever the devotees are, they celebrate this event by fasting until the moon rise.And then breaking fast with Ekadasi Prasadam.
时至今日呢，奉献者，全世界各地的奉献者仍然延续着这个，节日庆典。他们会全天戒食，白天戒食到月亮升起的时候，之后用 Ekadasi Prasadam 打破戒食。
So we hope all the devotees will also celebrate this event today and chant the holy name more and pray to get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
我们希望，奉献者们也今天一起来庆祝这个庆典，唱诵圣名，更多的唱诵圣名，并且祈祷。能得到主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈。
All right, so we will stop and ask if there's any questions.
我们讲课就到这里，接下来是回答问题。第一个问题来自于 Nitai Das。主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 显现有三个原因，哪三个原因？谢谢。
Due to three reasons.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared. There are three reasons for him to appear. So what are those three reasons for his appearance?
Well, he wants to experience that pleasure which Srimati Radharani was experiencing.
一个原因是他希望去体验 Srimati Radharani 体验到的这种快乐。
There were three points mentioned. One was to experience the wonderful qualities which are there in Krishna.
一个是去体验圣主 Krishna 的拥有的那些美妙的品质，神圣的品质。
Another was to experience the love, the loving, the pleasure which she feels in loving Krishna.
第二个原因是去体验当 Radharani 爱 Krishna 的时候所感受到的快乐。
And then a special pleasure which she feels when she sees that Krishna is attracted to her.
他看到 Krishna 看到 Radharani 的时候被深深的吸引的时候所感受到这种特殊的快乐。
And so we said this was a confidential reason for Krishna's appearance in the mood of a devotee.
这是Krishna 显现的机密原因， Krishna 一位奉献者的心态所显现的机密的原因。
But the external reason for the Lord to come was to establish the Yuga Dharma, the chanting of the holy names.
除此之外呢，他显现的外在原因呢，是来建立年代宗教大法，是建立唱诵圣名的 Yuga Dharma。
And the Lord also has a schedule by which He will appear in every age. So there's the Yuga Avatar, the time for the Yuga Avatar. One time in every age the Lord comes. So His purpose was to come to fulfill that commitment is there, to come in every age. And He will, as the Yuga Avatar, He will establish the process for self-realization.In that age, the Yuga Dharma.
主他也有自己的日程，就是在每一个年代呢，他都会降临世上，这是他的承诺。他会在每一个年代都亲自降临，来确立那个年代的自我觉悟的方法。
So the Lord comes in every Kali Yuga, but the Supreme Personality of Godhead comes only once in the day of Brahma.
主在每个卡里年代都会降临，但是至尊性格神首在 Brahma 的一天当中只会降临一次。
In the other Kali Yugas, means there's in every day of Brahma there's 1,000 Divya Yugas, so there's 1,000 Kali Yugas in one day of Brahma. But the Lord only comes once in Kali Yuga, and the other 999, it will just simply be an incarnation of the Lord, but the Lord personally comes once in the day of Brahma, and that was what happened in this Kali Yuga.
那么有一千个 Divya Yuga, 也就是意味着有一千个 Kali 年代。主在其他999个 Kali 年代呢，都是他的主的化身降临。他只在一个 Kali 年代 ,Brahma 的一天当中的一个 Kali 年代亲自降临。所以这便是我们这个卡里年代所发生的事情，他亲自降临了。
So, I don't know where you're referring, where it's referring to three reasons why the Lord came. Generally we say there's the external reason, and then there's the internal, the special confidential reason to understand Radha's love for Krishna.
那我不知道您这个问题当中所说的主显现的三个原因，为什么要说它显现有三个原因？通常呢，都会说它显现的外在原因是什么，内在原因是什么？它显现的内在原因，它的特别机密的原因就是它想要明白 Radha 对 Krishna 的爱。
We could say, in every age, the Lord comes to give pleasure to His devotees, to establish the religious principles, and to destroy the miscreants. We
could say, 主每个年代都会降临来给予奉献者快乐，建立宗教，年代宗教，来建立宗教原则，来消灭恶徒，重建宗教原则。
Indeed, that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, "Yada yada hi dharma shaglanir bhavati bharata adbhutanam." Right? Krishna is saying that his mission in coming to this world in every incarnation is to give pleasure to the devotees, to destroy the miscreants, and to establish religious principles.So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did that.
在《薄伽梵歌》当中，主 Krishna 说，他的使命，他化身前来的使命就是给奉献者们快乐，消灭铲除恶徒，重建宗教原则。所以这也是，Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的使命。
In other ages, as Lord Rama, he would kill the Rakshasas, and Lord Krishna would kill the demons. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would change the demons into devotees.
主 Rama 显现，当主 Rama 显现在那个当时的年代，他杀死了那些恶魔，杀死了这些 Rakshasas。然而主柴丹尼亚降临的时候呢，他没有杀死这些恶魔，他只是变了他们，把他们变成，把恶魔全部都变成了奉献者。
Yeah. Okay.
下一个，柴丹尼亚马哈帕布的追随者都能去狗罗卡，不去外昆塔吗？ Can all the followers of 柴丹尼亚马哈帕布 go to 狗罗卡？Instead of going to Vaikuntha?
If they cultivate the mood of Gaura Bhakti, if they cultivate the mood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then they can go to Goloka. Yeah.
倘若他们培养的心态是 Gaura Bhakti, 培养的是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的心绪，就可以去 Goloka.下一个问题是自由。明白孤儿莲花组和所有奉献者，一普利玛是 prima 吗？今天怎样祈祷？
普利玛
？What's the？
普利玛 means the full moon。
普利玛，普利玛这个梵文词的意思是满月。
Yes, 普利玛 ，full moon。Today is, there's at night you'll see in the sky there's a full moon. So today is Gaura Purnima, the full moon of Lord Chaitanya.
Today is Gaura Purnima, 是主旨。 Gaur Purnima means refers to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or refers to the moon.
Gaura is Chaitanya, the name of Lord Chaitanya, and Purnima is the moon.
Gaura 是指的 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是他的名字，而 Purnima 是指的满月。
Yes, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appears on the day of the full moon.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是在满月之际显现的。是在满月这一天显现的。
So the moon is, you know, in the heat of the sun, the moon is very cooling. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is very kind, merciful.
比起太阳的灼热的光芒，那么月亮它是非常清凉的。所以同样 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是非常仁慈，非常非常仁慈，非常好心的。
OK, 还有问题吗？
Yeah, 下一个问题是how to pray today? What should be our prayer?
Well, we pray by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. Please engage me in your service. Our prayer, the prayer of the devotee is, please engage me in your service.
我们是通过唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 来祈祷，是我们祈祷，我们通过唱诵 Hare Krishna 向主祈祷说，请让我从事为你们从事服务吧。
Just keep chanting.
所以就一直在那里念诵。保持念诵，恒常念诵。
If you want to approach Lord Chaitanya, you have to go through Lord Nityananda. Lord Nityananda represents the spiritual teacher.
谁要是想要接近主 Chaitanya, 就要首先接近主 Nityananda。主尼提安南达是就代表着所有的灵性老师们。
So by the mercy of the spiritual master, then you get the mercy of Krishna.
凭借灵性导师的仁慈，人才可以得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
So Lord Nityananda, his service was to go and preach to people, to tell them to worship Krishna.Read the books about Krishna and chant the name of Krishna.
主尼天南达会向所有人去向所有人去布道，告诉他们你们要崇拜 Krishna， 阅读 Krishna 的书籍，唱诵 Krishna 的名字。
So we want to develop that mood.Like Lord Nityananda, to deliver the fallen souls, to try to engage them in Krishna consciousness.
So we hope to develop the Lord Nityananda's attitude to save Krishna, those fallen souls, to give them Krishna, to let them develop Krishna consciousness.
And in that way, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will be pleased.
这样柴丹尼亚马哈帕布就会对我们满意。
还有问题吗？
Two more. Yuvati Sachi, Hare Krishna, dear Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances, O Lord, to Srila Prabhupada. Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful avatar, but we cannot say that Lord Krishna is less merciful. Also, Lord Nityananda is considered to be more merciful than Lord Chaitanya, but we cannot say that Lord Chaitanya is less merciful. How then to understand which of them is more merciful and why. 尤阿特萨是对大师问，就是主柴坦尼亚是最仁慈的化身，但是我们不能说主 Krishna 就不比他仁慈。而且主尼加南达被认为比主柴坦尼亚更仁慈，但是我们也不能说主柴坦尼亚不如主尼加南达仁慈。所以怎样理解到底哪一个更仁慈？为什么呢
？Well, I explained to you that when Lord Krishna appeared, he told everyone to surrender, but he didn't demonstrate how to do it.
在课程当中已经讲过，解释说，当主 Krishna 显现的时候呢，他让人们臣服他，但是他并没有展示亲身示范如何去向他臣服。
And we see also Lord Krishna, he killed the demons. The demons were killed by Krishna.They got liberation, but they only got, say, you, well, some, not all, but some, most of them, they got impersonal liberation. Some few demons were lucky. They got better. But generally, they would get impersonal liberation.
并且当主 Krishna 杀死、铲除这些恶魔的时候呢，他是给予这些恶魔非人格的，通常是给予他们非人格的解脱，大部分是得到了非人格的解脱，但是某一些走运的恶魔，得到更好的解脱。
So Krishna doesn't give love of God very easily, very rarely.
Krishna 不会那么轻而易举的就给予对神的爱，这是对神者的爱，他很少能给予人们。
But Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was very merciful, that he did give love of God.
但是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 的的确确是非常仁慈的，他给予人们对神的爱。
And he didn't kill the demons, but he made them into devotees.
并且他没有不是杀死这些恶魔，相反，他把恶魔都转化成为奉献者。
And yes, Lord Nityananda, he is more merciful than Lord Chaitanya. Lord Nityananda is the representative of the spiritual teacher. He's the original spiritual master. So he is.Chaitanya, he's not different from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, but at the same time, he is different.
主尼加南达确实更加仁慈，他就代表了所有的这些灵性导师，他是最原初的灵性导师。他和主柴坦尼亚没有不同，但是他们也是有着区分的。
Because Lord Nityananda comes as a servant of Lord Chaitanya.
Chu Nityananda is the 以主 Chaitanya 的仆人的身份而来的。
Lord Chaitanya asked Lord Nityananda to deliver the people, to go and preach. So on behalf of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu,Lord Nityananda is giving mercy.
主柴坦尼亚马哈帕布就要求主尼加南达外出去拯救那些堕落的人们，去向他们传播 Krishna 之觉。因此，主尼加南达是代表主柴坦尼亚，他代表了主柴坦尼亚在给予人们仁慈的。
All right.
下一个问题，齐颂圣名是内在原因吗？To spread the Sankirtan, is the interior reason?
To spread Sankirtan is the reason, well, to spread the Sankirtan movement, to give the chanting of the holy name, is to clean the heart of people. By hearing the holy name, then it will take away all the contamination from the heart, all the dirty things which are in the heart, the lust and the anger and the greed and the envy, they can all be removed by the chanting of the holy name. But we should understand that the chanting of the holy name can be performed on all different levels. Some people will be neophytes, and so they will awaken some attraction for Krishna in the beginning, and others will be great devotees, and they will be relishing the association with Krishna through the holy name.
我们要知道唱诵圣名呢，它有不同的层面。那些出席的人们呢，就会被 Krishna 所吸引，而伟大的奉献者们，他们是通过圣名聆听圣名，他们就在跟圣名联谊，他们欣赏着圣 Krishna。
All right.
Okay, 顶拜古奉献者，超然知识是 Gyana 还是 Gyana Yoga？ 嗯，the obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, the questions that, Does transcendental knowledge refer to Jnana or Jnana Yoga?
Well, transcendental knowledge, simply, it may just simply be knowledge. It depends how you use the knowledge. It depends who's using it. Impersonalists, you know, Mayavadis, they can also be using transcendental knowledge. Their goal is to merge into the impersonal Brahman. But it can also be used by devotees. So if you just say transcendental knowledge, it can be both personal or impersonal. It may be yoga, it may not.
这超人的知识呢，它也可以指的是瑜伽的知识，或者是 Dhyana， 这取决于是谁在运用这些知识。非人格主义者，他们运用这些超人的知识来达到非人格的梵，日常。奉献者们，他们也可以运用超然的知识。Shruti Rupa Radasi， 亲爱的 Guru， 今天会有15到20人或者是妙 Prasada 唱诵。请问 Guru， 对于一点都不知道 Krishna 的人们，今天中午可以给他们吃大米饭之类的 Prasada 吗？我们可以只吃离开了死餐，陪他们一起荣耀吗？感恩。Shruti Rupa Devadasi said that today there will be 15 to 20 people. They will come to honor Prasad and to have kirtan. So Guru, for these people who know nothing about Krishna, can we provide rice Prasad for them in the noontime?
Yes.
For us, we own.
Okay.
Oh, 可以。That's all the questions.
Okay. So, Om Ganshi Guru Mani, Ganshi Sauda Functions and Ling Ting, T1, Om Juhu Niman, Jerit Kwaila, Ju Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Trusian Ritki Jai.
Jai. Thank you, Maharaj.
Thank you, Guru Mani. Hare Krishna.